Hallo zusammen, I'm your vlog Dave, and today I want to do something a bit different. I want to take the USA test, the USA quiz, so to speak. I'm German, and obviously Germans also get to know stuff about America. We learn and hear about a lot of stuff through news, the internet, and many different things, basically. But that doesn't mean that we know specific facts about the USA and how it's structured, so to speak, how it works. Most of my viewers are actually from the USA. They are Americans, or living in the US at least. So I'm gonna give this a try. It's 30 questions and hopefully 30 answers, even if it's I don't know, I don't have a single clue, like that pretty much. All right, let's begin. Oh, by the way, the questions are in German and I'm gonna translate them, obviously. Nummer 1. Einfacher Start. Wo fanden 1996 die Olympischen Sommerspiele statt? New York, Atlanta, Detroit, Seattle oder San Diego? Well, that's what I'd call a good start because I know the answer. Oh yeah, it's Atlanta. Nummer 2. Die Route 66 verbindet welche zwei Städte? Chicago und Los Angeles. Memphis und Los Angeles. Las Vegas und Chicago. San Francisco und Dallas. Oder Detroit und New Orleans.
Yeah, I don't know, I have to guess actually. Route 66. Like, that's the thing, you always hear about Route 66, whoa, such a famous road and whatever, it's really cool and fancy and stuff. And many Germans know the name of that, but I guess most Germans don't know what the starting point and what the end point, the ending point is, so to speak, the final destination, and that sounds like deathly almost, no, like the final city. I'm gonna go with San Francisco to Dallas.
Nummer 3. Die Hauptstadt von Texas lautet Austin, Dallas, Odessa, Houston oder San Antonio.
That should be Austin, Texas, because that is like the combination of terms you always hear. So, I'm pretty sure about this one, I'd say.
Nummer 4. Wie viele Einwohner haben die Vereinigten Staaten? Circa 230 Millionen, circa 250 Millionen, circa 370 Millionen, circa 190 Millionen oder circa 300 Millionen?
And that is another very good question. I'm leaning towards 250 million. Maybe it's more by now, I don't know, like this quiz is from 2007, I think. So, adding 10 years to that and the population rate. You know what, I'm gonna go with 300 million.
Frage 5. Wie heißt die Nationalhymne der USA?
God save the president. Sing and Live Free, The Blues Song, Nothing Else Matters oder The Star-Spangled Banner. That is The Star-Spangled Banner. But to be honest, I couldn't sing that. Like, I don't know the lyrics to that one. No, sorry.
Nummer 6. Was gilt als das Gründungsdatum der Vereinigten Staaten von Amerika? Der 4. Juni 1772, der 4. August 1798, der 4. Juli 1776, der 4. Mai 1802 oder der 4. September 1784?
The actual founding date of the US should be the 4th of July in 1776.
Frage Nummer 7. In welcher Stadt spielt die Basketballmannschaft Supersonics? Toronto, Miami, Portland, Washington oder Seattle?
I guess since we Germans do like basketball, but it's not the most common or the most popular sports activity in Germany at all. There might only be a couple of Germans knowing this, and I'm not one of them apparently. I'm gonna choose Seattle just because it makes it a, well, threesome alliteration. That sounds really strange, sorry. Three words that actually begin with the initial letter S. Supersonics, Seattle. Wow, fancy that.
Frage Nummer 8. Wer war der dritte Präsident der USA? Martin van Buren, Thomas Edison, Andrew Jackson, Denzel Washington oder Thomas Jefferson?
So the third president. I know that Thomas Jefferson was one of the first ones. Duh. But, like, was he the third one, though? I don't know. Maybe it is. Maybe Thomas Jefferson was the third president of the USA. I'm gonna go with that one.
Frage Nummer 9. Wie heißt eine bekannte Buslinie in den USA? Redwood Travel, Blue Lake Sites, Green Day Road, Greyhound Lines oder Yellowland Express?
I don't know. And I try to make a connection between the colors, like the mentioned colors in these answers, in these potential answers, and the USA pretty much. Blue Lake Sites. Never heard of any of those, to be honest. And plus, I mean, might be easier for me to answer that had I'd been to the US yet, which I haven't. I'd really like to go there, but it's pretty expensive, and we'll see about that, but I definitely intend to go there at some point. Like, my first initial thought was it might be Redwood Travel. Although they all sound kinda convincing, I'm just gonna go with Redwood Travel. But it's just a more or less clever guess. Rhyme.
Frage Nummer 10. Aus welcher deutschen Stadt stammt Levi Strauss, der die ersten Jeanshosen erfand? Buttenheim bei Bamberg, Herford bei Bielefeld, Andernach bei Neuwied, Arnsberg bei Dortmund, what? Oder Oranienburg bei Berlin?
Well, I was kind of surprised by the answers, to be honest, because Arnsberg is my hometown. No, I would have heard about that if he came from here. No. Or had come. I think he's dead by now, but, you know. Actually, I think I've read about that, like, a couple of months ago. I'm gonna go with Buttenheim bei Bamberg.
Frage Nummer 11. Wann fand das legendäre Woodstock Festival statt? Vom 15. bis zum 17. August im Jahre 1969, vom 10. bis zum 15. August im Jahre 1968, vom 23. bis zum 26. Mai 1967, vom 11. bis zum 16. Juni im Jahre 1968 oder vom 5. bis zum 9. Juli 1969.
So, I'm pretty sure it took place in 1969, but I don't know if it actually took place in July or in August. I'm gonna go with from the 15th to the 17th of August. Maybe that is correct, I don't know.
Frage 12. Der Central Park liegt in welcher amerikanischen Metropole? New York, Washington, Houston, Detroit oder Los Angeles?
That is a pretty easy one, because that is located in New York. And if this park was located in Germany, it would probably be called Der Zentralpark. Fancy. Not really.
Nummer 13. Zwischen welchem Bundesstaat und welchem Land liegt der berühmte Ort Key West? Zwischen Florida und Kuba, zwischen Alaska und Russland, zwischen Kalifornien und Mexiko, zwischen Louisiana und Haiti oder zwischen Texas und Costa Rica?
So I assume that it has to do with the geography, obviously to some degree, and I tend towards choosing between California and Mexico. On a side note, I don't think that Key West is like a really well-known term in Germany at all. I don't think.
Frage 14. Was ist der Beiname des Staates Kalifornien?
The Rising Sun State, the Bear and Beer State, the Orange State, the Golden State oder the Wine State?
Now that I think about it, I think what I'm referring to, or what I'm thinking of primarily, is the Sunshine State. That was what I thought of at first, but I think it's the Golden State, to be honest. California is the Golden State, just because the sun looks golden and humongous. No, like beautiful, obviously.
Frage 15. Was sind die drei größten Städte der USA? New York, Los Angeles und Chicago. New York, Atlanta und Chicago. Detroit, Los Angeles und New York. Los Angeles, Chicago und Detroit. Oder Los Angeles, New York und Atlanta.
My follow-up question would be like, is that related to the size, like the geographical size of the city, or the population, the amount of people living there? Either way, my first initial thought was, like the first option, New York, Los Angeles, and Chicago.
Frage 16. Die Hauptstadt von Ohio? Boston, Columbus, Santa Fe, Sacramento, oder Providence?
I think I've heard of Providence during the US-American election. I do think that Sacramento is another capital city, but not of Ohio, I don't think. Maybe Providence is a capital city, but not of Ohio. I'm gonna go with Providence.
Frage 17. Wann wurde die Prohibition aufgehoben und bedeutete das Ende der trockenen Zeiten? Im Jahre 1911, im Jahre 1945, im Jahre 1938, im Jahre 1933 oder im Jahre 1919?
I think that took place in the 1930s. 1945 is too late, I think. And both 1911 and 1919 are too early, as far as I know, so. I'm gonna go with 1933. But it could very well be 1938. I'm kind of undecided between these two options, to be honest.
Frage Nummer 18. Wie heißt der Karneval in New Orleans? Bill of Rights Day, Indian Summer, Mardi Gras, Spring Break oder St. Patrick's Day?
Mardi Gras is a typical example for a phrase that I've heard about a couple of times. And I'm sure many Germans have, but what is Mardi Gras? Spring Break. But isn't Spring Break related to, like, colleges and having some time off? Isn't that related to that? Indian summer is also a term that I've heard about. I think it is Mardi Gras, but I'm not 100% sure. I'm not even 50% sure. Maybe around 30 or 40%. But at least that's something.
Frage 19. Was ist das nationale Wappentier der USA? Der Grizzlybär, der Weißkopfseeadler, der Fuchslachs, die Butterfliege oder der Mustang?
So, I'm pretty sure it's the white-headed sea eagle. Der Weißkopfseeadler. I don't know the English term for that animal, I'm afraid. But I know that the eagle is der Adler, which is not to be confused with the German noun der Igel, which is the hedgehog. Ha! You can learn something every day.
Frage 20. Wo liegt die Insel Alcatraz? In der Bucht von San Francisco, Kalifornien. In der Bucht von Manhattan, New York. Vor Miami in Florida. Inmitten von Las Vegas, Nevada. Oder vor Long Beach in Kalifornien.
Again, I'm quite sure it's near San Francisco. And it's definitely not in Las Vegas. No. So that might be the location of Alcatraz.
Frage 21. Wofür stehen die 13 Streifen auf der US-Flagge? Für die 13 ersten Schiffe aus Europa? Für die 13 Jahre des Unabhängigkeitskrieges? Für die 13 Gründungsstaaten der USA? Für die 13 Metropolen der USA? Oder für die 13 ersten Präsidenten der USA?
Yes, yes, I think I know this one, because the 13 stripes refer to the 13 founding states of the US, so that should be the answer.
Frage 22. Welche Abbilder sind auf dem Walk of Fame am Hollywood Boulevard zu sehen? Die Abbilder von über 20.000 Pflastersteinen? Die Abbilder von über 40 US-Präsidenten, die Abbilder von über 700 Kriegsveteranen, die Abbilder von über 2000 Hollywood-Legenden oder die Abbilder von über 100 Dinosaurier-Skeletten.
The dinosaur skelet option is pretty hilarious. That would be kinda cool, actually. But it's obviously about Hollywood actors.
Frage 23. Nochmal Geschichte. Wann fand der Sezessionskrieg statt? Von 1982 bis 1984, von 1892 bis 1895, von 1939 bis 1945, von 1834 bis 1838 oder von 1861 bis 1865?
And here it's the last option that's the correct one, because I know that happened during the times of Abraham Lincoln, and it was North against South, and like the South was pro-slavery and the North was against slavery and all that stuff pretty much. That took place from 1861 to 1865.
Frage Nummer 24. Der Bundesstaat mit den meisten Einwohnern ist welcher? Georgia, Montana, Texas, Kalifornien oder New York?
I think it is Texas. I know that's like a really large state on its own, like geographically. I think it's Texas, although I'm not too sure.
Nummer 25. Was erfand Benjamin Franklin? Den Blitzableiter? Das Rad, das Fernsehen, die Dreifelderwirtschaft oder die Glühbirne.
He invented the Blitzableiter. Oh yeah, the lightning rod. Great job, Benjamin.
Frage 26. Wo liegt Pearl Harbor? Das am 7. Dezember 1941 angegriffen wurde. In Idaho, an der Grenze zu Kanada nahe Vancouver, im Herzen von New York, auf Hawaii oder in Vermont. I think Pearl Harbor is a part of Hawaii. It's located there. So, that should be that. And it's definitely not in the heart of New York. Frage Nummer 27. Wie heißt eine Baptistengruppierung, die vor allem im ländlichen Raum im Osten der USA beheimatet ist? Die Mormonen, die 5%-Nation, die Amish, die Seminolen oder die Quäker? Of course I know about the Mormons and the Amish people. I know that the Mormons have their big temple in Salt Lake City in Utah. So, I think that should be the Amish people. Frage 28. Wo wurde der Präsident John F. Kennedy ermordet? In Dallas, Texas? In Bismarck, North Dakota? In Chicago, Illinois? In Reno, Nevada oder in Orlando, Florida?
That might have been Dallas? I'm not too sure, to be honest. I know that happened in 1963, but I don't know where exactly.
Frage Nummer 29. Was ist die beliebteste Sportart der Amerikaner? Soccer, Baseball, Basketball, Diving oder American Football?
From my German point of view, I guess the three most popular sport activities are Baseball, Basketball and American Football. I think Rugby is also very popular, but American Football, Baseball... I'm gonna go with Baseball. I think that's the most popular one.
Und die letzte Frage, Frage Nummer 30. Zum goldenen Schluss, wer gab dem Kontinent Amerika seinen Namen? Der Häuptling Sitting Bull, Christoph Columbus, Amerigo Vespucci, Alexander Hamilton oder King Edward II?
I know that Christoph Columbus has found America in 1492, but I don't know if he actually gave it its name because he thought it's India and he didn't think of America at first. I don't know. I'm actually gonna go with Der Häuptling Sitting Bull. Good question though, but I'm not too sure.
Alright, let's see what the results are before this cam is gonna turn off because of the low battery. Amerika-Quiz. Gute Leistung, du hast viel Ahnung von den Vereinigten Staaten. Es fehlt nicht viel bis zur perfekten Wertung. Sie haben 23 von 30 Aufgaben richtig beantwortet. Im Durchschnitt haben die 8.495 Surfer, die das Quiz gemacht haben, 11,71 richtige Antworten gegeben.
That is quite cool.
And the cameras just turned off. Okay, so anyway, it's the end of the video. I hope you've enjoyed this, and if you did, leave a like and share this video. And if you've also taken the test, I'd be interested in your results and how you did in the comments down below. But anyway, thanks for watching. I'm your Vlog Dave. Tschüss und bis zum nächsten Mal.